Have you ever wondered how bidding strategies work in Google Ads? Like, have you ever gotten to this menu and wondered if you should choose focus on conversions or focus on clicks or focus on target impression share? Like, what exactly do you pick when you get to this part of creating your campaign? Well, in today's video, I'm going to explain to you exactly what you should pick, and I'm also going to explain to you how they work. But to do that, I need to introduce you to two people. Now, this is Bob. Bob is going to be our focus on conversions, and this is Dave. Dave is going to be our manual CPC. And let's imagine that these two are in an imaginary auction and they're bidding on this classic car, this beautiful classic car, and its market value is around $100,000. Now let's see how the auction goes. So obviously, Bob won the auction. Congratulations, Bob. But you know who the real winner is? Who the biggest winner is in this auction? It's actually the guy who was selling his car, because he made a cool $25,000 more than he would have if he sold his car at market value. Now, I want you to think about Google like one giant auction. Every single day, people are searching Google and companies are bidding against each other. Hundreds of companies are bidding against each other for those searches. Searches like car insurance, searches like dog food, searches like I need a 4K monitor so that I can do color grading properly on my Premiere Pro. Okay, sorry, I'm getting off topic. Anyway, companies are bidding every single day on keywords. But this is all digital. That means we don't get to see the auction happening in real time. We can, however, see who won the auction simply by looking at the top of the search results. So for example, if I put in car insurance, I can see the company that won the auction by simply looking at the top, and to your left-hand side, you'll see the word AD in bold next to it, and that's how I know it's an ad. And these auctions are happening all the time because people are searching Google all the time. So for example, from the time you started watching this video till this point in the video, about 17 million searches have been done on Google. And by the time you finish this video, that number will be around about 59 million searches. It's extremely mind-blowing how many people are searching Google and how many auctions are happening all at the same time. So where do bidding strategies fall into this whole auction thing? Well, bidding strategies allow you to decide how aggressive you want to bid in the auction. And you can be like Dave and you can be conservative. So you can set a limit as to how much you pay for a click. Or you can be like Bob and you can just go crazy, spend as much as possible, and always try and be in the top search results. Now, there's no bad and there's no good, but there's also a ton of different bidding strategies. And if I had to put it in this video would be 1 hour long. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give you the three most common bidding strategies and I'm gonna tell you what they do. And these are commonly the ones that you will encounter on a daily basis. So the first one would be your focus on conversions. The second one would be your focus on clicks. And your last one would be your manual CPC, which is my favorite, by the way. Now, when you choose focus on conversions, Google Ads is going to aggressively push your bids if they think a conversion is likely. And you don't have to do anything, you don't have to click on anything. They will do this automatically throughout the course of the day while your ads are running. But just know that Google will determine whether a conversion is likely to happen. And even if that conversion doesn't happen, you're still gonna have to pay for the click. The second one is focus on clicks. Now, focus on clicks is really nice because Google will take your budget, not be as aggressive, but they'll spread it throughout the day and they'll try and make sure that you appear in as many auctions as possible or as many searches as possible so that you can get the maximum amount of clicks possible for your budget. But what this means is sometimes there could be a good keyword and other people will outbid you and therefore they will outrank you in the search results. And the last one, my personal favorite one, that's the manual CPC. Now with manual CPC, you get to decide, just like Dave, you get to decide how much you wanna pay. If you say you wanna pay $2 per click, Google will not go over that $2 per click. And the best thing about it is you can set it on an individual keyword basis. So for example, if your keyword is web design and you're not willing to pay more than $20 for the keyword web design, you can set that up so that for web design, you're only paying $20. You're not gonna pay a cent more, which allows you to control your costs and also allows you to figure out which keywords you should be more aggressive on and which keywords you can be more lenient on or more reserved on. So that's the cool thing about manual CPC. All right, so which one should you choose? Well, I'm always gonna recommend that you start off with manual CPC with enhanced CPC enabled. Manual CPC is gonna allow you not only to be aggressive when you wanna be aggressive, but also it's gonna allow you to control your costs. And if Google tries to overcharge you or tries to get you to pay more than what a click is worth, you're always gonna be able to say, no, no way, this is my limit, this is what I'm willing to pay. On the other hand, Google is always, always, always gonna push you towards an automated bidding strategy. So Google is always going to tell you that automated bidding strategies are great for you and we use all of this wonderful AI and we're gonna get the best possible results for you. But just like the car in the earlier example, you're gonna end up most of the time paying above market rate. You're gonna end up paying above what you should for your conversions. Now, as you progress and as you start understanding how all of this bidding stuff works, then I recommend that you switch from manual CPC to an automated bidding strategy if it makes sense to do so. But never ever just start off a campaign and try to just focus on conversions, because I know it sounds real good, but you can end up costing yourself a lot of money in a very short space of time. And once you've paid for those clicks, you can't get that money back. So guys, I've got a confession to make. That video that you just saw, that was actually cut out of my brand new Google Ads course. Now what we do in this course is we teach you how to get clients and how to set up your Google Ads, but we do it without any of the technical mumbo jumbo. So we've got over 12 hours of video, just like that, teaching you how to set up good Google Ads, and we try and make it as fun as possible. It also includes coaching calls, and when you set up your ads, you get a little ad cheat sheet that shows you every single bidding strategy. It explains it to you and it shows you the pros and cons of using each bidding strategy. So if that's something that you'd be interested in, and if you really want to be serious about your ads and start getting those good results, then check out the link in the description below. And lastly, thank you so much for watching this video towards the end. If you are using a bidding strategy right now, let me know which one you're using in the comment section below. Also, please like, subscribe, and share this if you found value in this video. And as a special bonus, you can check out this playlist over here, and that's my beginner playlist. So if you're brand new to Google Ads, it's the perfect place to start. My name is Devin, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.